This lecture is again about resolution. Recall that the resolution rule reads, if we have a clause P or V and a clause not P or W, we may conclude a new clause V or W. And this is a sound method to prove that the formula in conjunctive normal form is unsatisfiable. Note that we can only prove that the formula is unsatisfiable, or maybe satisfiable, but we cannot answer other questions directly. But sometimes by a simple transformation we can do this. For instance, if we have to prove that some formula phi is a tautology, that means it's always true, how to do that? Well, that's just equivalent to stating that not phi is unsatisfiable. So, if we have a formula for which we have to prove that it's a tautology, just take a negation of this formula and apply a satsolver on it. And try to prove it by resolution. That's what a satsolver essentially does. If we have to prove that one formula implies another formula, let's say phi implies psi, then we have to prove that phi and not psi is unsatisfiable. So the idea is, assume that the property is not true, so assume that phi holds and psi does not hold, we have to derive a contradiction. So if we can prove that phi and not psi is unsatisfiable, we can conclude that phi implies psi. To prove that two formulas, phi and psi, are equivalent, well, then phi, by implication psi, should be a tautology. So the negation of phi by implication psi should be unsatisfiable. And it may be convenient to observe that this formula is logically equivalent to phi or psi and not phi or not psi. Intuitively, this means if phi and psi are not equivalent, then one of them is false and one of them is true. And that's exactly what this latter formula states. And if the formula is not in CNF, then first we have to apply a Zeitung transformation, as we will see later. Let's consider an example. And this is an example which is free after Lewis Carroll, the author of Alice in Wonderland. Assume that good-natured tenured professors are dynamic, grumpy student advisors play slot machines, and a lot of similar requirements, then we have to prove that no student advisor is smoking. How to treat such a problem? Well, the first step, of course, is give names to every notion to be formalized. Let's say good natures, we give the name A, and the opposite of good natured is grumpy. Tenured, we give the name B. Professor, we gave the name C, and so on. And now we can transform our problem to assume properties 1 to 12, exactly the requirements as given, and we have to conclude that no student advisor is smoking, and this formula stating that not M and F should hold. And as we just said, if we have to prove an implication, we simply assume that the assumptions hold and the conclusions do not hold, and from that we have to derive a contradiction. So we have to prove that the formula consisting of the requirements 1 to 12 and M and F, this formula is unsatisfiable. Every property 1, 2, 3 and so on can be written as a clause, as follows. For instance, look at the first one. Good-natured tenured professors are dynamic. And good natures we called A, tenured we called B, professor we called C, and dynamic we called D. So this claim states that if A holds, if B holds and if C holds, then we can conclude D. Stated in a formula that's A and B and C implies D, and this is logically equivalent to the clause not A or not B or not C or D. So we have to prove that the following big formula is unsatisfiable, the conjunction of all of these 14 clauses. How to do that? Well, we will apply unit resolution. That means if we have a unit clause, in this case M and F. If we have the clause M, we may remove every not M in the rest of a formula, and similar for removing not F. And if we do so, and we remove the remaining M and F, the resulting formula is this formula, already has become a little bit smaller. But observe, by doing so, we introduced a new unit clause, namely not L. So now we can do unit resolution on not L, meaning that we may remove L from every other clause. And if we do so and remove the clause not L, we get this formula. And again, we see that a few new unit clauses have been created, A and H. So we can continue, no need to think about it, completely mechanically we can continue. We may remove not A everywhere and not H everywhere. And then we have this formula, and again two new unit clauses have been created, B and K. So doing the same for B and K, we get this formula. And now we have seven clauses remaining, but now there is no unit clause anymore. But we can do resolution. For instance, if we look at clause 5 and 7, 5 reads I or J, 7 reads not I or E. If we do resolution on I, we get J or E. And now we have the clause J or E, but clause 6 reads not J or E. If we do resolution on these two, we get the new clause E or E, which can shortly be written as E. So now, by this resolution step, we created a new unit clause, and now we can continue by unit resolution. Let's do so. The remaining formula only consists of these four clauses, and again a new unit clause has been created on which we can do unit resolution. And then, after a few steps, we see that we can both derive G and not G, and then by unit resolution on G and not G, we derive the empty clause, and we have proved that the original formula was unsatisfiable. We saw that how tautologies, implications and equivalence can be proved by proving unsatisfiability of a modified formula, and we applied this to solve a classical puzzle from Lewis Curl. And the resolution strategy we apply here, we apply unit resolution as long as possible and only do other resolution steps if no unit resolution is possible. Thank you.